Now, from what I see here, you can see that at some point they're putting in a narrow gauge railroad here. It looks like it's about half done. And now the Falk engine is running. Just fired it up here. You got something there. Second cam is a partial compression release right here. You can see it coming along. You just move this over for when you're starting. Now,
that was in a boathouse in a port called Seldom Go By in New Brunswick,
yeah,
which is the most eastern seaport in North America. Used to pull boats up and, you know, out of the river.
And here's a domestic water pump.
Nice.
Is that yours?
Yep.
Nice.
No, it ain't mine.
Not yet.
Not yet,
right? And we're back with Arch Display, fine Stirling cycle engine. They're running now, some of them are anyway. Now this one here, this one came from the Officer Steam. And Arch done a great job putting it on a plinth and putting a nice brass tank with it. It's a great engine. Henrici style engine. Excuse me. Thank you, I'm filming. All right, hi, thank you. One of my favorites here, a couple of these down here that Art built himself, his own design. This is made out of an old Fairbanks scale stand. Here's another of my favorites that Art built himself. And another. Hi, Wayne.
Hey.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Making the morning round. Morning.
Morning, Gil.
How are you? Oh, you can stay there. You're not in the way. Bring it on up.
This is my kind of overcast.
Yeah. I wanted to find out. Hey, Gil, how you doing?
Good. How are you doing today? Hi, Mike. How are you?
Good. Good.
Good.
Mike, I'll see you around.
Take care, Mike.
Enjoy you later.
We'll see you, Al. Yeah. Bye-bye.
What was this one?
Globe.
Globe, that's it. Yeah. There was two of those at Waitley, right? Yours and another
mine
one?
And the one that I can't buy.
That happens sometimes.
Well, I can buy it, but he wants triple what I paid for this one, so, you know.
So he can hold on to it a little longer. Yeah, there you go.
I'd like to own it, but...
Yeah. What's this one?
That's a Crosley something or other. Before Crosley was Crosley, they took over another company. This
okay.
is a dual flywheel version that they had. It's a
yeah.
freelance model made in England.
Nice. Got a runner?
Yeah. Yeah.
Want to fire it up?
Yeah, if it will. Which, oh, I took the fuel out of it. I was having problems because
oh, okay.
of the...
Here's an old Fairbanks Morse. That's a nice one, 8 horsepower. How you doing?
Hi, David.
Something you don't see too often. A tank-cooled woodpecker, 3.5 horsepower. Here's an old Mack truck, nicely restored. B70. B70 Mack. Here's an orchard sprayer, whole rig on skids. Nice looking restored Stover. Here's an old fire truck with a group of John Deere's on it. Here's a McCormick M. Driving a pump, a Gould water pump. And here's an Avenel.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Good, you?
6S?
Yep.
All right. Well, here's another one of those lawn tractors. When a little too much engine is never quite enough, you could at least throw a V8 in it. And here's a great one with a 60 horsepower Ford flathead V8. Here's another engine that's fun to look at. Ford. Here's a nice F-100 Ford pickup truck. How's it going? Here's a nice old Buick, straight 8. What's that?
It's a 6-cylinder. Straight 8,
that's... Oh, yeah. I counted an inlet port as an exhaust. 6-cylinder Buick, thank you. How are you doing?
Hey, Gil.
How are you doing?
I'm good. Nice to see you.
What a beautiful day we had.
Oh,
here.
Perfect day. Doesn't get any better. You have the serial number on this one?
Yeah. Okay, Nicholas, look on the top here. Actually, it's right here. 17196.
17196. Okay. Brent likes to know what's around.
Yeah. Oh, he knows about
this. He already knows. This one's good. And I won't have any surprise for him.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Good. Looks like a woodpecker. How are you?
Good.
Now we're going to look at a flute hopper aero motor and a regular aero motor. Here's an 8-cycle aero motor. And here's an 8-cycle aero motor, 1915. And here's a 2.5 horsepower flute hopper aero motor.